也欢迎参与线上主日的弟兄姐妹们，你们好。
Shalom brothers and sisters, online as well as physically here with us.
Amen.
那我们先来祷告。
Let us all pray.
是的，亲爱的恩主耶稣基督，我们可以来到你的面前。
Yes, dear Lord Jesus, we come before you.
谢谢你常与我们同在。
Thank you for always being with us.
主啊，谢谢你爱我们。
Thank you for loving us.
主，我们来到你的面前，可以卸下我们的劳苦重担。
We come before you to lay down our burdens and worries.
单单来亲近你，聆听你的声音。
We just focus on one thing, which is to draw close to you and listen from you.
求主圣灵今天透过你的话语来向我们说话。
Holy Spirit, please speak to us through your word today.
主啊，叫我们在你的真理里面得自由。
So that we can be set free in your truth.
奉主耶稣基督的
名。In the name
Amen,
of Jesus, we pray. Amen.
好，今天呢，我们继续来就是刷新存在感啊，这个的 PowerPoint 可以动一下吗？
Let's continue with the
今天我们继续来刷新我们的存在感了，就是来提醒我们我们存在的目的和价值是什么。
So make our presence count, it actually focuses on, you know, reminding us what is the value of our existence.
我们说每样的东西它的存在都有它的目的。
So every object exists for its purpose.
如果失去了存在的目的，就失去存在的价值。
So if it has lost its purpose of existence, then it has lost its value.Can you listen to what I'm saying now?
你们听不到是因为我关了麦克风。
Yeah, you can't hear Reverend here because yeah.
那你看，如果这个麦克风它摔坏了，它不能够再播音了，它就失去了它的目的还有它的价值，我们就不能够用它了，对不对
？So if this mic is spoiled, then you know it has lost its purpose, hence it has no more value.
我们人是按照神的形象和样式所造的。
So we are created in the image of God.
神赐给我们多产、倍增、掌权的能力。
God has given us authority to multiply.
就是要我们在地上按照他的旨意在地上执行他的使命，建立他的国度。
So that we can carry out His will and His mission to build His kingdom on earth.
这就是神赋予人生命的目的、意义还有价值。
So this is the purpose and value and meaning of God giving us life.
上个星期我们已经看了就是神给我们四个的身份还有一个的使命。
So last week we have seen that God has given us four identities and one mission.
就是在彼得前书的第二章第九节。
First Peter chapter 2 verse 9.
这个侍从的身份呢？就是蒙拣选的族类，君中的祭司，圣洁的国民，属神的子民。
So we are chosen people, royal priesthood and holy nation.
神给我们这四个的身份，就是要去执行一个的使命。
So we have these four identities to carry out one mission.
这个使命是什么呢？就是要我们去宣扬那位召我们出黑暗就入奇妙光明子的美德。
So we can, you know, declare the praises of the one who has called us out of darkness into the wonderful light.
就是叫我们为他做见证，传扬他的名。
So that we can testify for him and share his spread.
以致那些听到他的名而呼求他名的人也得到拯救。
So that those who listen to his name and call upon her name call upon his name will be saved as well.
他们也好像我们一样呢，能够脱离黑暗的权势，成为神光明的儿女。
Also leading us out of the dominion of darkness to be God's children of light.
我们也说到呢，主耶稣来到人间呢，就是要去寻找和拯救世上的人。
So Lord Jesus has come to earth to seek and find those who are lost to save them.
而今天他把这个使命呢，托付给教会，就是我们。
So today he has entrusted this mission to church, which is us.
我们看到了第一个的身份。就是蒙拣选的族类。
So the first identity is the chosen people.
你看，我们人很在意有没有被人选中。
So we are very mindful of whether we are being chosen.
然后我们也很看重我们在地上短暂的身份。
We also emphasize our temporary identities.
但是我们常常却忽略了是神拣选我们，给我们有个永恒价值的身份。
But many times we neglect the identity that God has given us that carries eternal value.
神赋予我们这个的身份，需要承接一个。又伟大又永恒的使命。
God gives us this identity to inherit the glorious and eternal life.
他分派我们，就是差遣我们去多结果子。
He has sent us out to multiply and bear fruit.
而且是长存的果子。
It's everlasting fruit.
他也预定我们得救，拣选我们得救。
He has also predetermined us and chosen us to be saved.
就是叫我们永远脱离黑暗的权势，脱离死亡。
Leave the dominion of darkness and death forever.
而他也会保守我们得救到底。
And he can also protect us to be saved.
没有谁可以把我们从神的手中夺去，即使是魔鬼。
So nobody can actually take us away from God's hand.
但是我们要坚持，特别是在这个幕后的时代， 我们要坚定我们的信仰，我们紧紧的依靠神。
But in this end time, we have to hold on to our faith and follow God tightly.
好，然后呢？我们也看到另一个身份就是君尊。君尊的祭司，神不只是给我们拣选我们成为蒙拯救永不灭亡的一个的群体。
So second identity is royal priesthood. So God doesn't just choose us to be, you know, an immortal or ever living a group of people.
他也赋予我们一个的君尊祭司的身份。
He has also given us an identity of royal priesthood.
我们君尊是因为我们所服侍的神，他是荣耀的神。
We are royal because our God's only Son is glorious.
那主耶稣他没有叫我们离开这个世界。
So Lord Jesus didn't ask us to leave the world.
他只是叫我们活在一个世界，但是却不属于世界。
He just asked us to live in the world, but do not belong.
他叫我们分别为圣，不与这个世界同流合污。
Ask us to be set apart and not be following the patterns of the world.
然后他差遣我们进入世界的当中，去传扬他天国的福音。
And He has sent us into the world to preach the gospel of His kingdom.
所以这是刚才我说的，都是我们上一篇的信息一些的问题。
These are some revision from the past sermon.
今天我们再看第三个的身份是什么呢？圣洁的国民。
So let's look at the third identity, which is a holy nation.
又叫做圣洁的国度。
It's also a holy kingdom. Yeah.
我们就是神国度的国民。
We are the citizen of God's kingdom.
什么叫做国民呢？
What do we mean by citizen?
有国籍的人就叫做国民。
Those with a nationality, it means you are a citizen.
没有国籍的人叫做难民。
If you do not have a nationality, it means you are a refugee.
你看难民是很可怜的。
So refugees are very pitiful.
难民是没有身份、没有地位、没有特权的。
They do not have identity, special privileges.
他们四处的漂流。
They wander around.
他们不能够投票，不能够工作。
They have no rights to vote and.
他们的孩子也不能够上学。
And their children cannot go to school as well.
所以我们拥有一个的国家的公民权是非常重要的。
It's very important for us to have a citizenship.
因为当你有公民权的时候呢，你就受到这个国家的承认，这个国家的保护。
Because when we have a citizenship, then we are protected and recognized by the country.
会可以享受这个国家所赋予给你的这些的特权。
And you can also enjoy the privileges that this nation gives you.
你看，今天我们活在这个世界上，但是我们的身份却是天国的国民。
So we live in the world, but we belong to God's kingdom. We are God's kingdom citizens.
我们拥有天国的公民权。
Of God's kingdom.
这个的天国的公民权是不会 expire 的。
So yeah, this citizenship will not expire. It will not. Yeah, it has no expiration date.
你不要把它弄不见了，在你的心里。所以呢，当我们是属天神的国民的时候呢，神就会保护我们，他会照顾我们，他会供应我们。
When we are God's citizen, that He will protect us, He will take care of us, and He will provide for us.
你看，我们活在这个世界，我们受到这个世界很多的动荡的影响和冲击。
So we are faced and affected by the storms and waves of the world.
我们也当然会受到这个的瘟疫的影响，这个的经济的不景，这些的饥荒等等，都会影响我们。
We are affected, you know, by the waves of pandemic, probably yeah.
但是我们呢，是属于神的国民，神会保护我们，他会供应给我们。
But we belong to God's kingdom, so He will protect us.
我们虽然面对很多的挑战，但是我们可以依靠神呢，去面对胜过一切的患难。
Even though we face many challenges, but we can rely on God to overcome all these challenges.
弟兄姐妹们，这个的疫情使我们很多人都受到影响。
But this pandemic has affected a lot of us.
很多人的婚姻，很多人的家庭。
Many marriages and families.
人际的关系，我们的工作，我们的财务。
In the personal relationship, your finances and your.
不是为什么我们是神的儿女？为什么神没有保护我们
？God, aren't we your citizen? Then why are you not
protecting us? 但是，即使是在这个困苦的当中呢，我们的君王他会照顾我们，因为我们是属天的国民。
But even in our troubles, God can protect us because we are His citizens.
那在最近呢，这个是前几天的新闻呢，我们知道有个马来西亚的。公民，他就在新加坡贩毒，然后被抓到了，判了死刑。
So this is a news, a recent news whereby a Malaysian was actually caught in drug trafficking, and yeah, he was sentenced to death.
但是据说呢，他是智障的，很有可能是被人利用的。
But he has intellectual disability, so probably he was being used by others.
所以呢，我们的政府，包括我们的元首、我们的王，都出面去向那个新加坡的总理求情，可以宽赦他。
So our King Yang Tuan Agong has even, you know, written a letter to President of Singapore to appeal for clemency.
你看，这是个人，他不是什么的大人物，他只是一个犯了罪的囚犯，一个的死囚。
So he's not a prominent figure. He's just a drug trafficker which has been sentenced to death.
为什么 连我们的国王也会向他为他求情了。
And how come our king will actually appeal for such a person?
因为他是我们国家的公民。
Because he's our citizen.
你看，在有的国家的公民呢，也有不同的等级的哦。
Of course, citizenship has different levels as well.
哦，在一些的国家有一等公民、二等公民、三等公民。
The first class, second class, third class.
哦，某些的族群呢，他们就是一等公民。
And certain races, you know, they are first-class citizens.
一等公民就会受到特别的优惠。
First-class citizens will enjoy, you know, special privileges.
哦，可能孩子呢就可以得到特别的奖学金。
嗯 ，probably children getting special scholarships.
哦，工作呢就可以在政府部门或者是在这个国营公司呢，承担很高的职位。
And probably they can hold high positions in the government sector.
那么其他的族群如果是二等公民、三等公民，就要靠自己的奋斗，靠自己的努力。
And what about second and third-class citizens? Then they have to rely on their own toiling.
但是弟兄姐妹们，即使我们在这个世界，我们是第二等、第三等、第四等的公民，但是我们是属天的公民。
Even though you know probably we belong to second, third, or fourth class citizens, but we belong to God's kingdom.
神会在，他会看顾我们。
He will protect us.
就好像当年的以色列人呢、啊，他们就在埃及呢被压迫。
Israelites back then they were oppressed in the Egypt.
他们被欺压，他们被迫成为奴隶。
And they were enslaved.
奴隶连二等、三等都不如啊
！So slaves are not even second, third, fourth class citizens.
但是神却拣选他们，呼召他们成为神的国民。
But God has chosen them to be His holy people.
今天以色列民，他们被神磨练成为全世界最优秀、最成功、最勤奋、最刻苦耐劳的一个民族。
So today Israelites have been trained and molded by God to be the most excellent and diligent and outstanding.
所以神把他们从埃及呼召出来，然后在生命记，神就对他们说。透过摩西对他们说
，So in Deuteronomy, God actually spoke to them through Moses.
他说：“因为你们是归耶和华你们的神做圣洁的子民的，耶和华你的神从地上的万族中拣选了你，做他自己的产业，自己的子民。
For your people holy for the Lord your God, the Lord your God has chosen you out of the people on the face of the earth to be His people.
然后在生命记十四章第一节，他说：因为你们是属于耶和华你的神的圣洁子民，耶和华从地上的万民中拣选了你们，特做他自己的。”子民
Yes, out of the peoples on the face of the earth, the Lord has chosen you to be His treasure possession.
你看神在旧约拣选了以色列百姓成为他的子民。
And the Old Testament God has chosen the Israelites to be His people.
但是今天神在耶稣基督里拣选你跟我成为他的子民。
But today in Jesus, God has chosen you and I to be His people.
你看他把我们从这个败坏的世界里面。呼召出来，成为他的国民。
He has called us out of, you know, a corrupted world to be His people.
你看这个世界是一个败坏的世界。
So this is a corrupted world.
因为这个世界是在魔鬼的手中，他的影响的当中。
This world is in the hands of Satan and is under his influence.
这个世界它只有越来越败坏，它不会变得越来越好。
So this world will only go downwards and it will not become better.
我们不要期待，哦，这个世界会变得更公平、更公义、更美好。
We don't have to anticipate the world to become fairer or more righteous or justice.
只有当主耶稣再来的时候，这个世界才会变得完美。
Only when Jesus comes again, then this world will become perfect.
你看以前有一首歌叫做《明天会更好》。
So there was a song that says, you know, tomorrow will be better.
啊，英文是 We are the world.
Yeah, we are the world.
你看这首歌唱了二三十年了。
This song has been sung for many years.
但是世界有没有变得更好？明天有没有变得更好
？But has the world become better？
好像明天每一天每个明天都有更差，对不对
？It seems as though the days are getting worse.
但是弟兄姐妹，我们不需要绝望的。
But we don't have to be in despair.
因为我们不是没有盼望的子民，我们不是在这个没有盼望的世界的子民。
Because we are a group of people that's not without hope.
我们是在耶稣基督里。有盼望的。
We are a group of people that has hope in Christ.
因为我们知道他掌管明天 ，Amen.
Because we know that He reigns tomorrow.
好，给耶稣一个掌声。
Amen. Let's put our hands together for God.
他是掌管昨天、今天、明天的神。
He is the God of our past, present, and
明天可能我们的生命里面有很多的不知数，很多的不确定。
Probably there are many uncertainties in our life.
可能你对明天感到很惧怕。
Probably you are afraid of your future.
但是你知道，耶稣是在为你掌管明天的主。
But you know that your God, Jesus, reigns your tomorrow.
是活在这个世界，我们不需要因为这个世界的这个的问题，这个不公平，我们就感到很绝望、很沮丧。
So we don't have to feel in despair because of this unfairness in the world.
我们不需要就跟这个的世界被这个世界同化，跟这个的世界妥协。
We don't have to be assimilated by the world or compromise with our
values. 因为我们害怕在这个世界。我们面对不公平的待遇的时候，我们就会吃亏，我们就会吃苦。
So we don't have to worry that, you know, because of the unfair treatment, then we will suffer.
那我们就把自己变成跟世界一样。
Then we become like the world.
但是主叫提醒我们，就是叫我们在任何的困境之下，我们可以依靠神去得胜，去突破重围的。阿门。
God has chosen us so that in all difficult situations we can choose to follow God。
你看，在神的国度里，我们都是神的子民。
So in God's kingdom, all of us are His citizens。
人人皆祭司。
Everyone is.
Is a priest. Everyone is a priest. 意思说，每个人都同等级的。
Yeah, everyone is equal.
你看在教会里面我们没有分、哦、你是神职人员，你是在教会全时间的同工，你就是一等公民。
So God doesn't classify us like, oh, if you're a co-worker, then you're a first class citizen.
你是比较圣洁，比较亲近神。
Or you're more holy, or if you want to become holy, then you have to draw closer to God.
当然亲近神的时间肯定会多一点、啊
哦、Of course, you know, you will gain.
然后其他的弟兄姐妹就是在职场的平信徒，二等、三等公民。
Oh, then, or those who work in a workplace, then you are second class, third class citizens.
不是的，
no,
因为在神的眼中呢，人人都平等。
Because in God's eyes, everyone is equal.
只不过是我们服侍的岗位不一样。
It's just that we serve in different areas of.
有些人是在教会做祭司。
So some people become priests in the church.
有些人在职场做祭司。
Some people become priests in the workplace.
有些人在家里做祭司。
Some people become priests in their home.
所以我们每个人都可以尽我们的本分。
So all of us can fulfill our duties.
今天因为这个疫情呢，带来了新的常态。
So because of this pandemic, there's new norms.
我们今天呢，要在同时之间呢，实体的聚会还有线上的聚会。
We have to have both physical and online service.
但是我们不能够把实体聚会的弟兄姐妹跟线上聚会的弟兄姐妹分成不同等级的。
But we cannot segregate these two groups of people into different classes.
当然，来到实体聚会肯定有它的好处。
Of course, coming to a physical church has its own benefits.
我们可以互动，可以交流，至少我讲到还有人会点头。
We can interact.
虽然看不到你的笑容。
When I preach, somebody will nod their head.
我还有掌声。
So, yeah.
那个是这一座镜头是没有的事。
But if you preach to the screen, then.
是我们还有参与感，我们有真实感。
So we have a sense of participation.
你会看到，哎，牧师原来是真的。
And then you think, oh yeah, pastor is real.
但是，也有一些弟兄姐妹，他们因为某些的原因，他们不能够来到实体的聚会。
Of course, some brothers and sisters, because of some reasons, they are stopped from coming to physical service.
They are not able to come.
Yeah.
So 有些可能是生病的，可能是家里有老人家有小孩。
Probably they are sick, or you know, family there's children.
然后他们就只有在家里聚会。
And they can only attend a service from home.
但是，在线上的聚会也有它的好处。
But of course, there's also benefits with online service.
There's also advantage. There are also advantages. Yeah. 意思是说，可以容纳更多的人。
It can accommodate more people.
意思说，刚才我说到一些某种原因，他们不能够来实体聚会，或者是他们去了远方，但是他们跟教会保持连接，也可以透过这个网络。
Probably they are unable to come because of certain reasons, or they have traveled to another country, then they can stay connected.
但是主对我们的要求，对我们的心意是什么呢？
But what's God's will for us?
就是让我们尽心、尽心、尽意、尽力的来爱他。
Is to love Him with all our heart, soul and mind.
所以，如果我们来到主日，我们来到实体的聚会，我们只是抱这个的心态，我只是来报道，我只是来打卡，不然我的组长就会追我。
So if we come to physical service with the intention that you know, oh, I'm just checking in, or you know, so as to.
如果我们不是带着，不是心存敬畏的来到神的面前来敬拜。
So if we do not come with a heart of reverence to worship our God.
这也不一定是神所喜悦的。
Then this is probably not what God delights in as well.
但是因为我们有某种的原因，我们不能够来到实体，我们必须在家里参与这个主日线上的主日。
If because of certain reasons we are unable to come to join physical service,
那我们就要那么我们就要在家里呢，好好的爱主，好好的敬拜主。
And when we worship Him wholeheartedly from our home,
那我们就好好的守主日。
Then we observe our sermon, our service.
我们不要躺在床上。就是开着那个手机敬拜。
We don't just lie on the bed, you know, and turn on our phone and just worship by lying down.
半睡半醒。
Half asleep.
唱到一半就安息主怀。
And after halfway through, then you fall asleep.
也不要只是对着那个的电视机，一面听牧师讲道，一面吃鸡脚饭。
Then don't just, you know, keep watching the sermon and eat your 鸡脚饭。
而是我们诚心实意地来到神的面前敬拜他。
But we come with all our heart and mind and soul.
这也是讨神喜悦的一个的侍奉。
This is a,
Amen.
a serving that is the.
因为作为牧师，我当然很希望教会很快的恢复。
Of course, I hope that the church will be restored as soon as possible.
As a pastor.
Yeah.
我也很希望教会很健康的成长。I also wish that the church will grow healthily.
Yeah, grow healthily.
Okay, can you? Okay. 我讲到哪里了？哦，但是神更期待我们呢，全心全意来爱他。
But all the more God anticipates us to love Him with all of our heart.
你看，作为马来西亚的公民
，as Malaysian citizens,
yeah, 我们每一天都是马来西亚的公民。
Every day we are Malaysian citizens.
啊，不管我们去到哪里，还是
no matter where we go.
除非你决定移民，你放弃你的这个的国籍。
Unless you have decided to migrate and forgo your Malaysian citizenship.
啊，同样的，我们不只是在礼拜堂才是基督徒。
Of course, we are not just Christians on Sunday service.
我们不只是在教会才是基督徒。
We are not just Christians within the boundaries of church.
不是我们每一天在我们的家里，在我们的职场，啊，每一天我们都是神的子民。Amen.
Every day in our family and in our workplace, we are God's people. Amen.
你看这里讲到神的国民啊，它有一个的特性。
Here it says there's a characteristic or nature of
这个特性，它就是圣洁的子民。
It's a holy people.
圣洁是什么？圣洁简单的说就是分别为圣，与世界不一样。
To be holy is being sanctified from the world and set apart from the world.
如果我们作为一个的基督徒，但是我们却活得不像基督徒，就是非常的可怜。
So if we are Christians but we do not live like Christians, then it's very pathetic.
你不属于世界。但是你却跟世界没有什么两样。
You do not belong to the world, but you are no different from the world.
两边都不到岸。
Yeah, then you don't gain anything from both sides.
以前你还没有信主的时候，哇，你犯罪，你做什么，你都没有问题。
So before you accepted Christ, you know you sin and you committed crimes or whatever. Yeah, but
you didn't feel
it doesn't matter. Yeah, you didn't feel anything.
但是今天你信主之后呢，你做了不对的事情，你的良心会责备你。
But today, if you do something wrong, if you sin, then you will feel your conscience speaking against you.
很痛苦，是不是？一方面你是基督徒，有圣灵在你里面；一方面你就在最终抓了大权。
Yeah, you feel really struggling because on one side you're God's citizen, you want to be holy, but on the other side you're sinning.
你看，我们不能够在教会，我们就是哇，很圣洁哦。
So we cannot be just holy within the boundaries of church.
哇，你的敬拜。
We worship.
哇，你是组长。
And you're leaders.
哇，你服侍主。
And you serve God.
都很好。
It's all very good.
但是去到我们的日常生活，在你的职场，是哦，就是完全变了一个人。
When we go to our daily lives in our workplace, then we have turned into another person.
不诚实哦，然后就是不负责任，常常跟人家吵架
，and always fight with one another.
骂粗口
，you know, bad,
vulgar
words.
然后呢，就是讲黄色笑话
，and yellow jokes, dirty jokes.
啊。卡勒夫总，你不说你是基督徒还好。
It's better for you not to say that you're Christian.
你说的时候，别人会嘲笑你、轻视你。
Once you say that you're Christian, you know people might
原来基督徒就是你这个样子。
So Christians are like that.
你反而成为拦阻别人信主的一个你成为别人信主的一个拦阻。
Then you're actually hindering people from accepting Christ.
你看，在彼得前书同样的，在第一章他说：“那照你们都是圣洁的，你们在一切所行的事上也要圣洁，因为圣经上记着说，你们要圣洁，因为我是圣洁的。”
But just as the one who called you is holy, so be holy to be holy in all you do. For it's written, for be holy because I'm holy.
你看十五节他说：“那因为照你们的是圣洁的，是因为那圣洁的神先照你们。”然后呢？所以呢？你们在一切的事上都要圣洁。
So the one who created you is holy, so be holy in all you do.
As a result,
as a result,
就是十六节说，你们要圣洁，因为神是圣洁的，圣洁的神呼召我们，所以你们要圣洁。
So the holy God has called you, hence as a result, you have to be holy.
所以你看到那个的因果关系啊 ，the cause and effect 啊，是圣洁的神先呼召我们，结果我们要圣洁。
So it's the Holy God that has called us first, hands and soul. We have to be holy.
因为不是因为我们圣洁决定我们圣洁国民的身份，不是说神说，哎，你这么圣洁啊，哦，你这个 pass 来传给我圣洁的国民，不是的。
So it's not our holiness that determines our identity. It's not that you first become holy, then you gain this citizenship.
而是因为神先赐我们这个圣洁的身份，圣洁国民的身份，才能够使我们活出圣洁。
But it's because God has given us identity, this holy citizenship, then only it makes us live in holiness.
你看，如果你很努力去模仿一个的王子、一个的公主，你就不会变成王子和公主的。
So if you try your best to become like a prince or princess, but you cannot become a prince or princess.
但是如果你是出生在这个的王族，你生下来你就是公子、公主，你就是王子。
But if you're born as prince and princesses, then you are naturally.
你就会自然而然地活出王子公主的这个的生活。
Then naturally you live the lifestyle of a prince and princess.
一只小鸡，一只鸡对他自己说：“如果我学会飞了，我就变成天上的老鹰。”
So a chick actually told herself that, oh, if I learn how to fly, then I'll become eagle.
但是不管他怎么努力地去学飞，他都不能飞。
No matter how much she tries, she can't fly.
但是那个老鹰一生下来，它就是老鹰，它生下来它就会飞。
But the eagle is born as eagle; it naturally can fly.
飞是鹰的天性。
So flying is the nature of an eagle.
有没有看过猴子做把戏
？But have you seen, you know, monkeys in a circus?
哇，猴子它就扮人的样子，穿人的衣服在那边跳舞。
So the monkey actually, you know, put on the suits and attire as a human and dance around.
然后骑脚车。
Cycling.
哇，逗到大家开怀大笑、拍掌。
You know, entertaining everyone.
但是每个人都看得出他是一只猴子。
But everyone knows that he's a monkey.
他怎样扮，他怎样学，他都不是人。
No matter how he pretends or you know, put on a show, but he is not human.
你说圣洁不是因为我们是基督徒，而是因为我们在基督里。
Holiness is not because we are Christians, but because we are in Christ.
我不是说你做了基督徒多少年，你就是圣洁的。
Not numbered by the years that you have become Christians.
而是在意我们有没有在基督耶稣里。
But it depends on whether we are in Christ.
意思我们跟耶稣的关系是不是很密切的
？Are we having an intimate relationship with God?
你看宗教、律法主义不能够变把我们变成圣洁。
So the laws cannot make us holy.
可能到某一个的程度，你很努力的去尝试，但是你不能够成为圣洁。
Probably at a certain point, you try very hard to observe the laws, but you cannot become holy.
行为也不能够叫我们成为圣洁。
Our behaviors cannot make us holy as well.
我们圣洁只有一个的方法，就是靠着耶稣基督的宝血洗净我们一切的罪。
We can only become holy by the precious blood of Christ Jesus.
那我们靠着耶稣成为圣洁，我们就会活出圣洁的生命、
and、
圣洁的行为。
Through the holiness of Christ Jesus, then we can live out holiness.
就好像一个的小孩。
Just like an infant,
一个 a little child, 不小心掉进沟渠里面，全身都又脏又臭。
So he has fallen into the drain, and then he has, you know, it's dirty.
被拉出来的时候，妈妈就为他梳洗一番。
Then the mom has actually helped him to clean.
跟他换上新的干净的衣服。
Put on a new and clean clothes.
他只需要做的就是保持干净。
He just has to maintain his cleanliness.
不要再掉进沟渠里。
And don't just fall into the drain again.
偶尔弄脏了，抹一抹，擦一擦，洗一洗就能。
If sometimes you know, certain parts get dirty, then you know just wipe it off and clean.
但是一只猪
，But if a pig,
你把它冲洗干净
，After you clean it,
你一转身，它又跑到泥巴里面打滚。
The next moment, it will go back to the you know down.
你看，圣洁不在于道德操守，而在于与主的关系密切。
The holiness lies not in morality, but in intimacy with the Lord.
不要误会我，我不是说基督徒我们不要有好的道德、好的行为。
I'm not saying that we don't observe a good moral behavior.
我不是说基督徒我们可以随意的犯罪。
I'm not saying that Christians can sin freely.
我说圣这个的道德操守行为是圣洁的结果，而不是达到圣洁的途径。
I'm saying that morality is not a means to holiness, but it is the outcome of holiness.
我再说一次啊，道德行为不是圣洁。要达到圣洁的途径，而是圣洁一个的结果。
So let me repeat, morality is not a means to holiness, but it is the outcome of holiness.
圣经教我们呢，我们的行事为人要以我们蒙召的恩相称。
God has taught us that in the Bible that we have to live out according to His calling.
Yeah.
In accordance with His
calling. Live our life worthy of our calling. 意思是说，我们活出来的生命要以我们蒙召的恩相称，先有蒙召的恩，才有。行事为人
There's first grace to be called, then only we have this behavior.
蒙召是一个的恩典，不是我们赚取的。
So being called is a grace. It's not something that we earn.
所以神先，我们先蒙召，神先呼召我们，然后我们才有行事为人。
So we are first being called, then only we have a moral
behavior. 你看宗教跟律法主义，教我们要很努力的，你要去遵守很多的这个的律法、道德、行为。
So religious laws actually teach us to follow closely and tightly on all the rules and behaviors.
要把你变成升级之后呢，希望神说好，我接纳你。
So to become striving very hard to be holy, then only be accepted by God.
但是我们的信仰告诉我们，圣经告诉我们
，Our faith and the Bible tells us，
我们是在耶稣基督里无条件的被神接纳。
In Christ Jesus, we have been accepted unconditionally by God.
我们先被他接受，我们先被他。被他转变成为一个的圣洁的子民。
We have been accepted and transformed by Him into a holy people.
然后我们就依靠住在我们里面的圣灵去活出圣洁，那个就自然的有良好的行为。
We rely on the Holy Spirit to live out the good morality in our lives.
然后我们看到使徒保罗的挣扎。
So we see the struggles of Apostle Paul.
他保罗还没有信主之前，他是一个的很严谨的法利赛人。
Before accepting Christ, he was a strict Pharisee.
哦、他遵守所有的律法。
He observes all the laws and regulations.
他比其他的法利赛人更法利赛人。
He was more of a Pharisee than the other Pharisees.
他甚至以为逼迫基督徒是为侍奉神。
He thought persecuting Christians was actually a way of serving God.
但是他在大马士的路上遇见主，他的生命才改变。
But on the road to Damascus, then he met God and his life was transformed.
后来在罗马书第七章他怎么说呢
？What he says in Romans chapter 7.
保罗说：“在我的里面没有良善。”
Paul says, "There's no good in me."
他说：“我立志行善，由得我；但是行的是否行出来，由不得我。”
So I'm willing to do good, but the good, the bad that I do not want to do, I can't help.
决心我要做一个好人，
yeah.
我不要犯罪，但是不由得他。
I'm determined not to sin, but he couldn't control.
那保罗说：“他说我想，我愿意行的善，我却没有去行。”
The good that I'm willing to do, but I did not do.
但是我不愿意所做的恶，我却偏偏去行。
But the evil that I do not wish to do, I kept doing.
那保罗说。我真是苦啊
！So what a wretched man I am！
谁能救我脱离罪的这个律法呢
？Who will rescue me from this body that's subject to death？
谁能够救我脱离呢
？Who can rescue me？
后来他说：“但是靠着耶稣基督，我就能够脱离了。
”But in the end, he says, "Thanks be to God who delivers me through Christ Jesus."
保罗知道他已经很努力的遵守律法。
Paul was observing the laws,
但是他却不能够成为圣洁。
But he could not obtain holiness.
唯有站在耶稣基督里。
Only when in Christ Jesus.
Amen.
Amen.
所以真正的圣洁是与主耶稣基督亲密的关系的一个的结果。
So true holiness is actually a fruit or outcome of the intimate relationship.
跟耶稣很亲近的时候，就自然会变成圣洁。
When you are very intimate with God, then naturally you will become holy.
圣洁就自然的有道德跟行为。
Then when you are holy, then naturally you will have good morality.
而不是调转来 the other way around.
Yeah, it's the other way around.
It's not the other way.
It's not the other way around.
所以，你看哦，所以我们就是靠着耶稣基督先成为圣洁，那个就是自然的。
So when we rely on Christ Jesus to become a holy, then that the holiness will come naturally.
就好像当你跟一个你很尊敬的人。或者是你很爱的人在一起的时候
it's like when you are with someone that you love a lot or you respect a lot
你就不会做他不喜欢的事对不对
then you will not do something that displeases that person
你不会在你爸爸妈妈面前看色情片
you won't watch you know, pornography in front of your parents、
哦、在他们背后也不要看啊
course,
但是、啊、你肯定不是在他们面前看的对不对
but definitely you will not watch in front of them
你不会在 你的女朋友的面前挖鼻孔
you will not you know, dig yournose in front of your girlfriend.
因为你知道我在你很爱很亲近的人，你不会做他们不喜欢的事情。
You will not do something that your lover doesn't like.
如果我们常常，我觉得主这么爱我，我跟主这么的亲近。
If you have this intimacy with God and you know that God loves you and you love God,
你每天住在主的同在里面。
You always live in His presence.
不只是你不敢犯罪，你根本就不想去犯罪。
Not just that you dare not sin, you don't even want to sin.
我主耶稣这么爱我，我主啊敬拜主。
Oh, the Lord loves me and I want to worship Him.
突然间你的手机滴滴跳出一个的视频短片。
Then suddenly your phone, you know, there's a notification on a new video.
你会看吗？哎、
will you watch?
Delete, 不要看。
No, you will delete.
哦，因为主与我同在。
Because God is with me.
所以因为这个的关系，我们就自然的活出圣洁。
So when we have this intimacy with God, then naturally we live out holiness. Amen.
然后最后一个的身份就是属神的子民。
And the final identity is a people belonging to God.
我们一起来宣告，我是属神的子民。
Let's proclaim that.I am people belonging to God.
这个很重要。我们的身份尊贵，是因为我们是属于神的。
Our identity is honorable because we belong to God.
你看一个东西，一个物件呢？哦，谁定义它的价值？
So、
它的价值在于什么
？Who actually determines the value of an object?
主要有三个关键。谁是它的原创者
who the original creator is.
如果他是一个的很杰出的这个作家所做的，他就很有价值。
So if it's out of a very famous artist, then probably it's a very good masterpiece.
然后第二就是人愿意以什么代价去换取它。
And the second point is at what price people are willing to exchange for it.
说的价位越高，它就越有价值。
So if it's at a higher price, then it will be more valuable.
第三就是他谁拥有它。
The third point is to whom it belongs.
如果 很出名的一个人拥有它，它就很有价值。
If a famous person owns it, then it becomes very valuable.
你看，近来在这个网络世界，有个新的名词叫做 NFT.
So there's a new term called NFT, non-fungible token.
Non-fungible token 中文就是非同质性代币。
Non-fungible token.
听得明白吗？非同质性代币。代币就是我们可以来换取别的动物间的一个的东西。
So token is like something that we can use to exchange for something else.
那么非同质性代币它的意思是什么呢
？Non-fungible, what does it mean?
我事先声明，我不是这方面的专家，我也不要识小小板代表。
So I'm not expert in this area.
我只是把我知道的大稍微讲一讲。
I just want to explain briefly from what I know.
意思打个很简单的比喻了。
Just like a simple example.
那如果你今天有一张一美金的钞票
，If you have a one USD $1 note
啊，一美金，今天你可以换大概四块、二十块、三四块多的马币。
So probably you can exchange for foreign twenty plus.
所以它的价值哦，一美金等于四块多的马币，同值。
One USD is equivalent to foreign twenty plus.
所以你就愿意用一美金去换别人的四块多的马币。
So you are willing to use one USD to.Exchange for foreign
因为它价值是同等的。
Because it has the same value.
但是如果你最上的一美元的面钞上面呢有林肯总统的亲笔签名。
So, but if you have the signature of the President Lincoln, on
可能是150年前他在他的朋友的这个钞票上签了一个名。
So 150 years ago, he has signed on this USD $1.
就被保留到今天。
It has been preserved until today.
那如果你拥有那个钞票，请问你会不会跟人家换四块多的马币
？So if you have that note, do you think you will exchange just for foreign
收藏钞票的专家在这里。
So we have expert of.Notes and
你看，虽然它的面值啊 ，face value 是一样的，一块钱。
Even though the face value is seemingly the same，
但是它的价值已经不一样了。
But the value, the true value is.
因为它有了林肯总统的亲笔签名。
Because it has a personal signature from President Lincoln.
如果你要别人要跟你换，他可能要吃40万呢、啊。
So probably somebody
不是四块钱
has to offer $40,000 just for that note.
你看以前呢、在以前呢，就只有那些实体的物件，它才有。拥有权，它才有价值的。
So last time only with a substance that you can
tangible object,
tangible object that you can have value.
Tangible things,
tangible things
can have ownership. 就是 the right of property.
Right of property.
意思，比如说你一个房子，你就签了合约，这个合约说你是这个房子的主人，这个土地注册局有注册。就是你有所拥有的。
So probably like a property, you know, after you sign and from the land office, yes, you are owner of this land.
你就可以住在里面，你就可以转卖你的房子。
Then you can stay in that house.
或者你有一幅的名画，很出名的画，你拥有它，但是你可以把它放在这个的 art gallery 这个的博物院画廊。
Probably you have a famous painting, then you put it in a museum.
每一个人都可以来观赏。每个人都可以拍照。
Or art gallery, then everybody can come and
张纸，而是在里面的内容。
So the value of a novel does not depend on the number of pages, but the content within it.
所以它的价值是在它里面的内容，那个就是你的知识产权。
So that's your intellectual property because it depends on its content.
所以如果你拥有这个的产权，别人要抄你的创作，你可以告他的。
So if people want to copy your invention, then you can actually sue that person.
所以从这个的物质的产权到了知识的产权，今天已经发展到这个叫什么？数码的产权。
So today it has transformed into digital property.
Yeah, digital property right.
Digital property.
意思说你怎样可以拥有一个的电子作品呢
？How can you obtain a digital property?
你把一个电子的作品放在网上，每个人都可以下载，每个人都可以去传递。
You put a digital property on the net, then everybody can download and share.
所以现在就透过这个 NFT 就是说你就可以透过它就是注明这个东西你是它的原创者。
So through this NFT, then you can prove that you are the original
就只有你拥有它
creator and you own it.
所以就透过那个的区块链 blockchain 这个区块链就把全世界很多的电脑连接起来。
So this blockchain has actually connected a lot of computers around the world.
所以所有的电脑都已经记录了这个东西谁是它的原创者，它卖给了谁。
So this depends on the original creator and whom he sells it to.
So 没有人可以随意的篡改的。
So nobody can change it.
因为它是连接全世界很多的电脑，你不可能全部都改。
It has been connected to a lot of.
所以只有某些人拥有它。
So only certain people own it.
哦，你就透过这个区块链是可以去贩卖的。
So through this blockchain, you can actually sell this.
虽然每个人都可以看见。
Of course, everyone can see.
虽然每个人都可以下载。
Everyone can download.
虽然每个人都可以传播。
Or probably everyone can share.
但是你是拥有者，只有你能够可以买它。
But you're the sole proprietor. You are the sole owner.
比如说这个的 NBA 就是美国的足球总会就放了一个的短片 ，LeBron James 灌篮24秒。
So yeah, the NBA has put on this video that you know this player has
dunking the dunking of LeBron James， 说他们知道是什么了哈。在这个放在网上就卖了$200,000。
It has been sold for $200,000 USD.
Yeah, 每个人都可以看到，但是只有一个人拥有。
Yeah, everyone can see it, but only one person owns it.
王明之的玻璃心呢，就放上去就卖了2000多万的台币。
Yeah, Namivi's video has been sold for 20 million.
你跟我的作品可以放上 NFT 吗
？So can your digital property or something that you create be put on this?
也是可以的。有没有人买就不知道了。
But whether or not people buy it,
所以我说就是，从这里我们看到谁是原创者，谁出价高，数一数。
So who the original creator owns this digital property?
Next piece. 所以谁是原创者？
Who is the original creator?
你看毕加索的画很出名，因为他的画家是毕加索。
So Picasso's art is very famous because the artist is Picasso.
虽然你看来看去都不知道画什么。
Of course, you do not know what the painting is all about.
但是因为是毕加索的作品，所以很有价值。
Because it is Picasso's painting, that's why it has.
今天如果你把它抄他的画，画的真的一样，完全一样，也是一个的赝品，一个的冒牌的，不值钱。
So today, if you copy and imitate his painting, it's at best just an
imitation. 因为你不是真正的原创者。
Because you are not the original.
但是我们的原创者是谁呢？神，创世纪告诉我们1:27，神是照着自己的形象创造人。照着他的形象创造我们，他创造的有男有女。
So God created man in His own image, in the image of God He created him, male and female.
所以我们的原创者是神，而且是按照他的形象的。
And our original creator is God, and is in accordance with His image.
不管你是男还是女
，whether or not you are male or female,
你都是神的形象所造的。
You're created in the image of God.
你不需要搞得很混淆。
You do not have to be confused.
到底我要做男好还是做女好呢
？Should I be a male or female?
如果神造你是男，你就是男。
If God has created you to be male, then you are a male.
神造你是女，你就是女。
If you have been made,
你就活出那个柔美的形象。
Female, you live out the glorious image.
因为神创造我们。
Because God has created us.
然后呢？第二，物件的价值在于人愿意以什么代价去换取它。
So the value of an object lies in what is the price that people are willing to exchange for it.
一个的新的花瓶，它可能只能够卖50元，50块钱。A new vase can only be sold.
New vase has been made. Then you
花瓶啊，花瓶。
Yeah.
新兴的，它只能够卖50元。
Yeah, probably sold for $50 ringgit.
但是一个老古董啊，乾隆行的料壶，可能卖到50万。
But if it's an ancient or China or whatever, then it probably can be sold for $50.
Much more.
$500k. Yeah, much more.
比喻了啊。你说那个尿壶你不会用它的吗？它的价值是谁愿意如果有人愿意出100万，它就值得100万。
So if somebody is willing to offer $1 million, then it's worth $1 million.
今天神出价多少来买我们
？So what is the price that God has given out to buy us?
我们本身有什么的价值
？What is the value that lies in us?
我们本来是死在最终的价值。
We are sinners.
最终的人。
That die in the sins.
但是上帝用他的独生儿子的。生命来换取我们。
But God has used the life of His only begotten Son to exchange for us.
请问神的儿子，他的生命值多少钱
？How much does it is the value of the life of His Son?
无价之宝。
It's a priceless gem.
比所有的天价还要天价。
Yeah, it's heaven.
Yeah.
Yeah.
beyond imagination. 所以你看神如果用他的独生儿子来换取我们的价值不是在于我们自己。
So if God has exchanged for us with his own son, then the price does not lie in us. 而是
神竟然愿意用这个的价钱来换我。
God is willing to use this price in exchange for us.
所以我们的价值不是我们争取回来的。
So our price, our value is not something that we strive for.
我们不需要去妒忌别人跟别人比较。
We don't have to be envious
of others. 不用去羡慕别人。
Or compare with others or be jealous.
我们也不需要骄傲。
We don't have to be arrogant as well.
因为一切都是属于神。
Because everything belongs to God.
他愿意用这个价钱换你就值这个的价钱。
He's willing to use this price to come and in exchange with you.
所以提多说二章十四节他说他就是耶稣基督为我们舍己为的是要救赎我们买赎我们脱离一切不法的事洁净我们做他自己的子民。
So he gave himself for us to redeem us from our wickedness and to purify for himself a people that are his very own.
热心三公。最后一个物件的价值在于谁拥有它。
The value of an object depends on who owns it.
你看这个足球明星啊 ，Cristiano Ronaldo。
So this football star Cristiano Ronaldo。
哇，他打完球的时候，他满身汗啊，他把那个衣服一脱。
Yeah, he was sweating badly, you know. And then once he took off his clothes.
然后他就向着那个的观众群一抛。
And then he just swing his clothes.
哇，全部人来抢啊！那些女球迷在那尖叫哇。
So all the female fans, you know, were screaming.
但是你在巴萨马龙奶奶的那一件啊。
If the one that you buy from another,
跟他穿的那件是一模一样的。
Despite being looking the same as the one that he's wearing,
没有什么两样。
There's no difference.
只不过分别是那一件是他的，这一件是你的。
The difference is that
他的价值就不一样
了。He owns that. Then the value is different.
如果你穿去打球
，If you wear it to play
badminton, 哇，满身臭汗。
Play badminton or whatever, then you have to.
把你脱下来一丢。
Then once,
全部人散开。
Once you take off and throw it to the crowd, everybody will run away.
就一个人撕起来
，Only one person take it up。
就是那个扫地的，就是把它撕起来，一面骂一面丢进垃圾桶。
Only the cleaner, you know, he will take it up and scold.
因为价值
，throw it to the bin。
那个谁拥有它是不一样。
Yeah, it depends on who owns it.
所以弟兄姐妹们，神给我们这个的身份。
God has given us this
identity. 第一，他是我们的原创者。
He's our original creator.
我们是照着他的形象所被造的。
We are created in His.
那荣美的形象。
His glorious image.
第二，他换取我们。用耶稣基督的生命来换取我们。
He has used the life of Christ Jesus to exchange for us.
第三，他拥有我们。
And third, he owns us.
其实是两次拥有我们。
He has owned us twice.
第一次是他给了我们生命。
First time was when he gave us life.
但是我们迷失的时候，我们失去的时候，他在第二次再买回我们。
We were lost and we went astray. Then the second time he came and buy us.
如果你造了一个东西，本来是属于你的。
So this thing originally it belongs to you.
You make it and it belongs to you.
You made it and it belongs to you.
但是别人偷去了，然后你要出钱再把它买回来。
But somebody steals it, then you have to pay a second price to buy it back.
因为你实在太爱它。
Because you really love it. You want to own it twice.
神拥有两次拥有我们。
God has owned us twice.
所以哥林多前书第三章十三节说：“你们是属基督的，基督是属神的。”
So it says, and you are of Christ, and Christ is of God.
我们再一次说：“我是属基督的。” Amen.
I am of Christ. Amen.
你看神给我们这四个的身份蒙拣选的族类亲尊的祭司
So God has given us four identities chosen people,
圣洁的国民属神的子民
Royal priesthood holy nation people belonging to God
就是去成就一个的使命
That is to fulfill one thing
就是去宣扬那位召我们出黑暗入奇妙子的美的
It's to declare the praises of the one who called you out of darkness into wonderful light
我们请敬拜团队 Hallelujah Amen 好吧我们一起站起来我们一起来祷告
Let us all stand and pray、
啊好吧，我们真的是在神的面前，我们真的谢谢神你自己的恩典。
Why not come before God and
主啊，你拣选我成为蒙拣选的族类。
That you have chosen me to be a chosen.
主啊，你给我君尊祭司的身份。
You give me a royal priesthood.
主啊，你叫我成为你圣洁的国度。
So that we can be a holy nation.
我是属神的子民。
And people belonging to you.
主啊，谢谢你。
Lord, thank you.
主啊，让我来到你的面前。
That I come before you.
主啊，不只是在我的理性上知道。
Not just in our rational mind that we know.
但是在我真正的。拿着神你赐给我这个的属天的身份
But I really carry this identity
我的生命我的人生不再一样
And my life is never the same
主啊你拣选我你呼召我跟世界是不一样的
Lord you have chosen and called me and I'm different from the world
主啊即使在世界我们面对很多的困难
Even in the world we face a lot of challenges
但是我们知道靠着你与我的同在
But we know that
靠着你给我们那属天的身份权柄和能力
We have this spiritual heavenly identity
主啊我们可以为你差遣
And we are being set
by you Amen Hallelujah 唱歌，第一首听的好的是好吧，我继续不唱，
真的是好感动，
不是我今天神主你这不是逼我的逼得我全心全意的
接
逼得我用我的生命来敬拜你，唯有耶稣，把你的心交给耶稣，告诉耶稣，主啊，唯有你，你得着我的心，把我的心交给你，恢复我的生命，不要你提起我的身份，恢复我成为真正的祭司，恢复我成为圣洁的子民，属神的子民，真实对耶稣什么？是主，这一美好的敬拜，最真诚的敬拜，现在的面前，不管我们是在这里还是在家里，我们向你献上的敬拜，在你的宝座前。哈利路亚，是耶稣。是主，我们要敬拜你，全心的来敬拜你，全心来赞美。你是不是你是我心中唯一的神主，唯有你耶稣。好了，我已经开口来祷告，谢谢主耶稣，我们感谢你，我们把这份的心意，我们感谢你，你是信实的真神啊，主啊，荣耀的君王，主啊，你是全心的主，全心的主，我心里是我我今天的真实愿意使我们完全完全降服于你，是心是真实荣耀于我们，我是自从你我认识你，你主我我心是我的完全真实。哈利路亚，弟兄姐妹，让我们一起来回应，我们回应神的呼召。
Let us
respond to his calling. 不管是我们在这里还是在家里的弟兄姐妹，我们单单来到主的面前。
We come before God.
主，感谢你让我成为被拣选的族类。
Lord, thank you that we are chosen people.
主，让我成为君尊的祭司。
That we become royal priests.
你圣洁的国民。
Your holy nation.
属神的子民
and people belonging to you,
主，我愿意我在这里
Lord, I'm willing, I'm here.
我愿意被你差遣被你使用
I'm willing to be sent by
your 我愿意用我的生命活出美好的见证
I want to live a good testimony of my life.
我愿意主啊向人宣扬你奇妙的作为
I want to declare your wonderful works.
我愿意让我的生命别人看见你的荣耀
I want people to see your glory.
阿们，好不好，我们一起来做这个名堂，我数到三的时候每个人一起开口来祷告
Let us pray.
社会应主耶稣我在这里一二三来，我们一起来祷告。圣主耶稣，我感谢你，圣主耶稣，是的主，谢谢你，主，我们能荣耀你的名。是的主耶稣，主，我们在这里，我们是你的教会，我们是你的儿女，主，我们愿意主为你活出美好的生命，主为你做出美好的见证。我们感谢耶稣，谢谢耶稣，主，我们把这一生跟随你，一生荣耀你，经历主能够的恩典，夸耀我们的恩典，领受我你无比的爱。做传递你们无比的爱，阿门！感谢耶稣，阿门！感谢耶稣，阿门！如果今天在我们当中，或者是在视频前
，If there's any among us, or before the screen，
有哪一位你还不认识耶稣
？If you have not known Jesus yet，
或者你听过他的名字，但是你还没有接受他
，Or if you heard about Jesus but you have not accepted him，
成为你的救主，你生命的主
，To be your personal savior，
今天你要邀请耶稣基督进入你的生命
，You want to invite Jesus into your life，
去得着他给你那个属天的生命，属天的。这个的位分
to obtain the life and identity from heaven，
活出一个截然不一样的人生
and to live out a totally different life，
为一个永恒的价值
having eternal value。
Amen， 你就可以跟着我一起来祷告。 Amen，
you can follow me after，
不管你是在这里还是在视频，你要接受耶稣基督，你就跟我一起祷告。
So you can follow after me。
亲爱的主耶稣，
Dear Lord Jesus，
谢谢你爱我，
Thank you for loving me，
用你的生命，
use your life，
救赎我，用你的宝血洗净我，你拣选我，成为那永恒的族类，让我成为君尊的祭司，在地上彰显你的荣耀，能够活出圣洁的生命，
做
你圣洁的国民， 我是属于神的，我是属于神的。我的今天，我的明天，我的人生，我的永恒，都在主你的手中。求主耶稣基督，你赦免我的罪，进入我的生命，成为我的救主。我生命的主，祷告，奉主耶稣基督的名，
奉主耶稣基督的名。